Four kids, A, B, C, and D, are in the habit of collecting tattoos and together have a stock of 360 tattoos. The number of tattoos with A is 2/7 of the total number of tattoos with the other three. Tattoos with B are 1/3 of the total tattoos with the other three. C has 4/11 of the tattoos with the other three people. Who has second highest number of tattoos? Who has second highest number of tattoos? Yeah, so see what needs to be done here. So basically four kids, let's assume the number of tattoos with each of them is like A, B, C, D respectively, right? A has got A tattoos, B has got B tattoos, C has got C, and D has got D tattoos. Now they together have a stock of 360 tattoos, meaning what? The sum of A, B, C, D is 360. Look at the next point. The number of tattoos with A is 2/7 of the total number of tattoos with the other three. Number of tattoos with A is 2/7 of the total with the other three, which means A is equal to 2/7 of the other three, B plus C plus D. You're able to follow? A is equal to 2/7 of the total number of tattoos with the other three, which implies that the sum of B, C, D, B plus C plus D will be 7/2 of A. The number of tattoos with A is 2/7 of B, C, D, which means B, C, D should be 7/2 times of A, reciprocal of that. That's it. Substitute this in the previous equation here in place of B, C, D, substitute that. What do we get? We get A plus 7/2 A, which is 9/2 A. A is already there. B plus C plus D can be replaced with 7/2 times of A. So A plus 9/2, A plus 7/2 A. A plus 7/2 A equals to 360. Now I'm not going to write the next step on paper because that may, make it lengthy and you guys will again complain that it's taking a lot of time, right? In my view, you can do it mentally, right? A plus 7/2 is 9/2 A. 9 goes 40 times here in 360. So A will be equal to 40 into 2. That 2 in the denominator gets multiplied, right? 40 into 2, which is 80. So in my view, A is equal to 80. Mental calculation without putting pen on paper. Similarly, if you look at the other statements, tattoos with B. Now, after this, you don't have to put any step on paper. Tattoos with B are 1/3 of total tattoos with the other three, which means A plus C plus D this time. A plus C plus D. Tattoos with B are 1/3 of A plus C plus D. B equals to, just visualize this, B equals to 1/3 of ACD. So ACD will be 3 times of B. If B is 1/3 of ACD, A plus C plus D, ACD or A plus C plus D will be 3 times of B. Substitute back. So B plus 3 times of B, which means 4B. 4B is 360. So B is equal to 90. B is equal to 90. Go to the next statement. C has 4/11 of the tattoos with the other three. C is equal to 4/11 of ABC, ABD. C is equal to 4/11, 4/11 of ABD. If C is 4/11 of ABD, ABD is 11/4 of C. ABD will be equal to 11/4 times of C. Substitute that back. So C plus 11/4 times of ABD. ABD is 11/4 times of C. So C plus 11/4 C. Again, mental calculation. C plus 11/4 C is 15/4 C. 15 goes how many times in 360? 24 times. Yeah, 24 times. So C by 4 is 24. So C is equal to 24 into 4, 96. C is equal to 96. Done. I've got three values. Now substitute back the values in first equation. You'll get the fourth value as well. A is equal to 80. B is equal to 90. C is equal to 96. So in my view, D will be equal to what? If I go by my calculation, I would say average is 90. So B has got 90. C has got 6 more. A has got 10 less. So balance is 4. We should go to D. So 94. D should be 94. Yeah, I have done using the concept of average equal distribution. You can do the regular check also. 80 plus 90 is 170. 170 plus 96 is 266. So 266 plus 94 will give you 360. So D is equal to 94. Now read the question properly. Many of you, I'm sure, will go wrong in the final step. Who has second highest number of tattoos? He's not asking us for highest number of tattoos. Who has got second highest number of tattoos? See, highest is 96. Second highest is 94. So answer should be D. The answer to this question should be D. The second highest number of tattoos are with D, which is 94. Highest is 96, second highest is 94. Similarly, lowest, second lowest, third lowest. Be careful, right? After having done the calculation, you cannot waste your time in... you cannot go wrong just because you have misread the question. Okay, answer should be D. The person D who has got 94 tattoos, because 94 is the second highest.